Hello everyone, this is Shannon from That's So Po, and today I'm here to do my recommendations and TBR for my May monthly priority, which is the Asian American and Pacific Islander Heritage Month in the US, and also the Asian Readathon hosted by Cindy at With Cindy. I'll have information about the Asian Readathon linked in the description box below. If you're not familiar with my monthly priorities, I do have a video about that and a playlist also linked below. But basically what I'm gonna do today is recommend a couple of favorite books written by Asian Pacific Islander heritage authors that I've read in the past year and loved, and then talk about my TBR for what I want to get read this month. So first, let me talk about my recommendations, starting with Kim Ji-young, born 1982, by Cho Nam-ju, translated from Korean by Jamie Chang. This is such an awesome literary historical fiction. It's a very short little book, and it has a real bite to it. It's got some really sharp satire and commentary on Korean society and really the gender issues that that has had from the 80s through today, as well as further in the past as well. We follow Kim Ji-young, who is sort of the everywoman, a stand-in really for the experience of all Korean women. And she is in her mid-30s and sort of going through a bit of a breakdown, and it's kind of looking back at her life and what led up to that. I absolutely loved this. I thought it was so good. I highlighted so many passages because I was just like, yes, this is such great commentary. I do have an entire standalone review for this, so I will link that below. Next, I'd like to recommend The Empress of Salt and Fortune by Nghi Vo. This is such a beautiful fantasy novella that takes place in a sort of low fantasy world where there's not a ton of magic. It's more focused on empire. And we follow a cleric who is going to interview the handmaiden of the previous empress, and the handmaiden is telling the story of the empress's exile. This is, again, a very feminist work. It is beautifully written, very atmospheric. I loved the amount of world building and character development that we saw in this very short little novella. I thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed it. It was one of my top books of last year, and I do, again, have a standalone review linked below. And lastly, I'd like to recommend The Best We Could Do by Thi Bui. This is a graphic memoir slash family history. Thi Bui's family was Vietnamese and dealt with a lot of very difficult situations in Vietnam in the 60s and 70s. And then they became refugees and moved to the US where she grew up. There is so much in this, really exploring that experience of being refugees and immigrants, and especially looking at the generational trauma and how everything her parents went through meant that they had a lot of issues that they then passed on to her and her siblings. I thought this was beautifully done, so beautiful, so heavy, so impactful, just really excellent. I definitely recommend this, and I also have a standalone review for this one linked below. Now moving on to my TBR for May. I have 7 books on my TBR, and these are not the only books that I'm going to be picking up in May, and I probably won't pick up all of these. My goal is to hopefully get to at least 5 of these, and I will definitely pick up other books that are by Asian heritage authors as well during the month. I'm going to be trying to also align what I'm reading with the Asian Readathon prompts. So let me put up a picture of the prompts right here. I believe that every book that I have chosen fulfills the first and second prompt. The first prompt is any book by an Asian author, and the second one is featuring an Asian character. So I'm pretty sure all of the books that I have chosen fulfill those prompts, and I will tell you what fulfills prompts 3, 4, and 5 as I go. For the Asian Readathon, you can combine different prompts in the same book, but you are supposed to choose different ethnicities, different heritages for each of the books that you use to fulfill prompts. I believe that every book that I have chosen, except for 2, share different ethnicities. There are 2 by Malaysian and Malaysian diasporic authors, but other than that, they should all be different. The first book on my TBR is Goodbye Vitamin by Rachel Kong, who is Malaysian American. This is a book that I've had on my radar for quite a while. It's about a woman in her 30s who moves back home with her parents as her father is developing dementia, and really how their relationship changes as his illness progresses. I've been very interested in this, but recently David at The Poptimist made a great video, which I will link below, talking about bookish influence of TikTok versus BookTube, and and really prompting BookTubers to go out and buy Goodbye Vitamin and show a little bit of muscle in the BookTube influence world. And I thought, you know, I've wanted to read this for a while, so I bought myself an ebook copy and I really want to get to it this month. Next on my list is The Red Threads of Fortune by Neon Yang, who is a Singaporean author who's also non-binary and queer. I believe that I put this on my TBR last year as well because I need to get to it. This is the second book in the Tencerit series following The Black Tides of Heaven, which I enjoyed and I want to continue. It is a kind of fantasy silk punk novella that follows some issues of empire and succession and rebellion and just very, very cool world building. This also fulfills the Asian Readathon prompt number 3 to read something in my favorite genre, which is SFF. Next on my list is Lalani of the Distant Sea by Erin Entrada Kelly, who is Filipino-American. This is a middle grade about a girl who has to go across the sea in order to find something to help her mother who is sick, and there's a lot of fantastical elements in it. This also fulfills the prompt of reading something in my favorite genre, which is SFF. Next on my list is Broken Stars, edited and translated by Ken Liu. This is a collection of translated Chinese SFF short stories that I've had on my radar for a while, and this month I'm going to be buddy reading it with Tori at Tori Morrow, who I will link below. I absolutely love Tori's channel for SFF recommendations, by the way. And I've just really wanted to read more translated works this year, so this is perfect. It fulfills also prompt 3 for the Asian Readathon of favorite genre, SFF, and it fulfills prompt 5 of a not US-centric work. Next on my list is Saigon by Phuc Tran, who is Vietnamese-American. This is a memoir about Tran being a refugee to the US in the 1970s, growing up in the 80s, and really embracing punk rock and dealing with a lot of issues of that immigrant experience. I've heard really great things about this, and this fulfills the prompt 4 of the Asian Readathon for nonfiction. Next on my list is Bangkok Wakes to Rain by Prachaya Sudbanthad, who is Thai American. This is a story that is set in Bangkok and really focuses on the feel and nature and composition of the city by looking at a bunch of different characters in the past, the present, and the future. It sounds very atmospheric and very interesting, so I'm really looking forward to this. And this fulfills prompt 5 of a not US-centric book. And lastly on my TBR is Ripples by Shi Li Kao, who is a Malaysian author. Previously, I had read Shi Li Kao's The Sum of Our Follies, which I absolutely loved. Freddie at Sluggish Reader, who's a Malaysian booktuber, has an entire review of The Sum of Our Follies, so I'm going to link that below because he convinced me to pick it up and I loved it. So I wanted to read more by Shi Li Kao, and so I got Ripples, which is this short story collection. I loved her writing in the previous book, so I'm really excited about this one. And this fulfills prompt 5 of a not US-centric book. Okay, so those are all of my recommendations and the books on my TBR for this month. If you guys have read any of these, if you have any other recommendations for me, any of the things on my TBR that you think I should prioritize, anything at all, just go ahead and leave me a comment down below.